Daniel Salas, S-A-L-A-S.
Daniel Salas. Oh, you got it. And Daniel Salas, sorry?
Daniel, D-A-N-I-E-L, Salas, S-A-L-A-S.
And your position, are you the owner here?
I'm the owner.
So, tell me a little bit about your restaurant, first and foremost, and I guess I'll say that you guys opened in November of 2019?
Yes, we opened in November of 2019. We've actually been working on the property since April of 2019, but our official open date was November 19.
So what was that like, because the pandemic ended a few months later, and all of a sudden, you know, businesses were affected everywhere?
It was tough, being a new business, especially downtown with all the offices, in the area closing kind of, and everybody going home to work remotely. We've seen a dramatic drop in our local walk-in customers. Everybody was working from home, and we were a new kid in town, so it was hard for us to build a clientele base during a shutdown. It wasn't easy.
Well, I know a lot of businesses have had to shut down, especially restaurants after everything you guys did over the last year. What have you been able to do to keep the business going? Obviously, good thing you're still here.
Yes, our online menu on our online order system has been a big help to us, and social media has helped out a lot. The Kalamazoo menu page has helped out a lot, just people's eyes on our new business downtown. I think we're in a very unique place downtown, being that we are a downtown business. It's a different crowd, you know, the parking is an issue. It's not easy to get down here sometimes, but people like to make the effort to visit us and make a destination to come downtown.
Is it also pretty competitive being a downtown restaurant?
I think it is competitive. A lot of people are looking for something different, and that's what we try to bring to the community. It's just our own choice on authentic Mexican food.
So then 25%, you guys are able to open at 25%. What was that like?
Yes, the 25% has been tough. We were just happy to be back open and greet our customers and let them sit down and have a cup of coffee. It's been tough through the shutdown, 25%, especially going from 50% back to 25%, and now back to 50%. We're looking forward to restrictions being relaxed and everything getting back to normal.
During that time, did you find that you were having to turn people away because there was a wait? Couldn't see, you know, enough people in here, or were you finding that less people were coming in because they didn't know if they could see? Were you seeing any of that?
Less people were coming in, I think, just because of the fact they were being cautious with the whole pandemic. A lot of people were comfortable with the takeout. Takeout has been very good for us. And I think people are just getting used to dealing with the pandemic, dealing with restrictions. So it's been a little mixed bag of a different variety of clients, all with different preferences. So we're just adapting and trying to make the best of the situation.
50% capacity, what are you hoping to see with that? Do you think it's
going to
dramatically help increase business?
I think it'll help customer confidence. We're hoping that people start coming in more relaxed and bringing their families and just getting some sense of normalcy back. But yeah, I think that 50% will help that. And we've seen the numbers already come up a little bit with restrictions being relaxed. So we're looking forward to that.
With the time that you guys have already spent closed, do you feel like it set restaurants back a ton overall, or do you feel like you guys are still on the rise now that you're seeing these openings even with restricted people have wanted loosened restrictions, but yeah, even with loosened restrictions, are you feeling like things are starting to look up, or was it being closed for so long that already hurt you a good amount?
Being closed for dining in did hurt, but the community rally, and our takeout game, our takeout has really been strong. People have supported the main campaign. I do believe that with 50% capacity,
I'm trying to think of how I want to word this. So, like, obviously, you guys were shut down for a long time, but like, stores were able to reopen, and all these places were open. The restaurants were really confined to what they could do. So it was like you guys were already in such a hole with the situation that the restaurants were in. Do you feel like it was, even with these like limited restrictions, it's still going to be hard to get business back for it?
Good enough.
Well, I can't speak for everyone, but for La Comunidad Cafe, I feel like we're in a
unique situation.
We have a different product that we offer than other Mexican restaurants. So it kind of sets us apart. We've been getting a lot of positive response from the customers that do come in. We get customers from Grand Rapids, Coldwater, Battle Creek, that come just for our food. So it's been a mixed bag of customers and responses. So we're very excited for the future. I feel like things are on the way up and gonna get better. So we're just keeping positive and trying to do our best to stay consistent and offer a good product.
Awesome. Well, that's all my questions. Unless you can think of anything else
with that. I'd like to just thank Kalamazoo community for supporting local businesses, everybody downtown especially. We need the help down here. Like I said, it's a different clientele base. We have a lot of office people that are still working from home, and we're looking forward to getting the courthouse back open and some of the offices full again, so we can get some of that foot traffic back downtown. Looking forward to some of the parades maybe coming back. Looking forward to some of the events downtown, maybe at Bronson Park, Arcadia Creek Festival sites. So we're looking forward to being a part of what downtown has to offer.
Yeah, absolutely. It smells great. I'm excited to try this at some point.
Yeah, we did my crazy comes in.
Oh, does it?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
We brought some of the team in.
Oh, yeah.
So
it's a little, we're on like a whole different shift than him, so.
Yeah, he comes in. You guys working late?
We get off at noon, so we start at 3 a.m.
Yeah. Wow.
Early
birds. Yeah, yes, we are.
Yeah.
Yeah, we always talk about
every
time we put it like 6 in the morning.
Like,
something
sounds
weird
because
we've been
out
for, you know, 4 hours already
or whatever. We serve authentic Mexican breakfast at 8 a.m. We serve authentic tacos at 8 a.m. So if you're in the mood for lunch tacos.
I love Mexican food, so. Yeah.
Lunch tacos at 8 a.m. you can get them here. I don't think there's anywhere else in town where you can go get